I graduated BS ME 1969. The dean of the ME school handed me my degree, and he looked at it and he said, go out, do your thing in life, and come back in 50 years and tell us how you did. So I'm here.
I didn't think I was ever going to go into engineering. I came from a family of history and English majors.
My family wasn't technical, but my dad had heard that Purdue was really good at engineering.
I knew that it was Purdue engineers and scientists that were involved in our country's very early parts of the space program effort. And so I decided in the fourth grade that I was going to go to Purdue, that I was going to become an engineer, and that I was going to get involved in our country's space program.
Okay, my mission in life to get into Purdue and become an engineer and get into the cooperative education program.
I was so blown away that like an institution like Purdue, which is so highly decorated and ranked within the U.S., would want somebody like me going there. I mean, I was just blown away.
I just couldn't believe that this big, huge school was so one-on-one that they wanted to talk to me on the phone and make sure all my things were right and all the plans were right.
It was an eye-opening experience when I got there. The facilities they had were out of this world. Just the whole campus and the vibe you got, it was something I'd never experienced before. Kind of transformed the way I looked at engineering.
When I went to Purdue, I was sort of undecided as to what I wanted to do with myself.
I was trying to find a project that not only did cool engineering work, but was also meaningful.
I really loved the mechanics of mechanical engineering, but I also loved biomedical side of things and medical devices, etc. So I kind of wanted to blend mechanics with biomedical.
Purdue would very flexibly let me sort of design my own curriculum.
Thermodynamics, go figure, is where I felt really comfortable.
For me, senior design is definitely the most memorable course. I think what was very obvious to me is that I like open-ended problems that have a ton of different ways of being solved.
This course, it's really taught me more than I expected.
Many, many lectures where I was like, wow, that is going to help me in racing, and it has.
It's always really nice to be able to take theory that you've learned in your education and see real-world application for it.
They said that they were building a full-size car, and I was like, that sounds awesome.
I personally learned TIG welding here, and I weld the chassis of the car.
I've had all this experience with 3D printing, laser cutting. I have all this background with computer-aided design.
I feel like I really got the chance to actually go through a full cycle of product development.
You had to mold your own product in the foundry, and you had to design a piece of machinery and then build it.
Being able to be there for the entire design cycle, which is something you can't do in industry very much anymore.
So like I would have been able to make this button, right? But would I have been able to machine it, to manufacture it, to make the mold that was gonna make this a reality and was gonna make 5,000 of them? That's what I wanted. I wanted to be part of the entire life of the product. And I was like, oh, this is amazing. Nobody ever told me that people could do this.
I was the first graduate student to move into the Burke Nanotechnology Center. I always considered it a privilege, and I still talk about that today, that a select few people get the opportunity to go in there to make something that never existed before a reality.
When you come from another school, you always wonder, you know, can I cut it here?
Mechanical engineering at Purdue, it's a little bit of a trial by fire.
Extremely, you know, competitive. It's definitely not a walk in the park.
Lots of long nights and lots of difficult assignments.
We had all this work to do, and you had to be on time and under budget and come up with a brilliant idea every so often.
I looked around and I also saw that there were a lot of people that were engineers that were perhaps better engineers than me.
There were a lot of classes actually that were tough.
And I really struggled with it. It was so freaking hard.
The biggest shock for me as a student was that I had to actually learn how to study.
It's not simply show up, here's your degree. You've got to work for 4 years and you've got to work hard.
It's the hardest thing I've ever done. And I say that proudly.
I think it was more rigorous than anything else I've done.
I remember spending all night in the computer lab trying to get that robot to climb a hill and drop a golf ball into a hole. I don't think we were ever successful at it, but we had a lot of fun trying.
Sometimes when you're working on something for, you know, hours on end, it can get kind of discouraging. Like, am I ever going to finish this? Is it ever going to work?
And it took a while to figure out what I wanted.
But when you do have those aha moments, it's like the best feeling ever.
I ultimately got a B in my first calculus class, which I'm still proud of to this day.
And I think that's part of what makes it such a great school is that it'll challenge you and it'll actually bring the best of you out.
I love being challenged every day from an academic standpoint, and you obviously get that in being in such a strenuous major.
College isn't a sprint, it's an endurance sport.
If you can get through Purdue's engineering, you can pretty much tackle anything.
I could adapt and overcome any challenge I could come across.
I know that moving forward, I can take it. I've done it before.
And once I left Purdue, I realized that there wasn't a mountain I couldn't climb if I didn't set my mind to it.
It just gives you that little bit of extra incentive when you come across a really hard problem or a really complex challenge to put in a little more effort instead of giving up to try and get over it. Because you know ultimately what you're working for matters, and it has the potential to really positively change people's lives around the world at the end of the day.
Purdue is an amazing place, and all the staff wants you to succeed.
Professor Jim Jones always says, kind of treat your education like a job.
I remember Professor Koskrill saying that the person who is most prepared will always be more successful.
Exceptions are how science is driven forward.
It's that famous quote by somebody.
Professor Yuan.
Oh, okay.
Professor King was a great mentor. I learned a lot from him. He helped me get in and he helped me adjust.
Tremendous faculty here at Purdue that have provided a lot of insight and assistance in my research.
What I love about mechanical engineering is it impacts every aspect of our life.
There's so much you can do with the engineering degree, and it was really hard for me initially to even know, like, okay, I'm a mechanical engineer, now what do I do?
You can go be a technical person, you can get into sales, you can get into operations.
You can go into law, you can go into medicine.
Mechanical engineers can do anything. That's why I chose it.
It's kind of like a Swiss Army knife. You learn a lot about a bunch of different areas, and the application of those is really broad.
When you think engineering, right, you're thinking, oh, maybe the automotive industry, maybe I'll make a plane.
Mechanical engineering doesn't have to just be bolts and gears. You can make something like this. You can do whatever you want with this degree.
So I had a master's degree in mechanical engineering. I ended up writing software.
I took that work that I'd done, applied it immediately to noise and vibration work at Ford Motor Company.
At the time I graduated, I had more job offers and job interviews than I knew what to do with.
I got 3 different engineering-related internships.
12 or 15 offers coming out of the school.
I got around 9 interviews last year for internships and had multiple offers in the automotive industry.
It gave me a lot of flexibility in not knowing exactly the career path later, that I could come to ME, get a lot of great foundations.
What I really am and ended up doing in life, I'm a problem solver. And that's what Purdue taught me.
Number one favorite thing about Purdue is how practical they are about real world problems.
Teaching me how to think and teaching me how to go about solving problems.
It'll impact the entire way you see the world, and you won't notice it because it's going to be so gradual as you get your education.
You learn a way to analyze and to dissect a problem into different pieces and put them back together and find a solution.
Look at what has to be done and figure out how to do it with the tools at hand. And if you don't have a tool, how to make that tool.
Here's the problem that was given to me. Here are the assumptions I made. Here's my analysis, here's my conclusion.
That structure has stuck with me from the days of writing on the green engineering paper. So I think it definitely applies on both the business side and on the engineering side.
The technical fundamentals are very well learned and applied, and that application is to the real world very efficient and effective.
Not only are we really good at theory or really good at academics, but we like to get in there and get up to our elbows in grease.
You can have a lot of good ideas, but the implementation of those ideas, it comes, you know, you've got to get into the details, and the details actually make it happen. And those skills and that training that I learned at Purdue actually helped me develop the processes and the procedures that actually help take those ideas and make them into reality.
I get to see something that I was doing in the lab go out of the lab, and there's nothing more exciting than that. Getting to help lives with it, there is nothing cooler than that.
It may not be the whole system. It might just be a little subset of the system. You know, on the Coca-Cola freestyle machine, I figured out how the button worked, and it was a really cool button, and it feels just right. If you look at anything, there's some little nuance that's a real crowd pleaser, and if you're the guy responsible for that, every time someone likes it, that high five comes back again. It's a cool feeling.
Everything that I want to pursue in life and everything that I want to do as an engineer, I've been able to learn and figure that out here.
It's a special place and a special community for one to develop oneself into a better person. When you're here, you have an opportunity to be immersed in this intentional experience of being in the Boilermaker community. To me, there's no better training for life in the challenges of the complex world that we live in.
I wouldn't trade this for anything.
Almost everything I did throughout my entire Air Force and NASA career was directly tied to my academic career here at Purdue.
My years at Purdue were actually probably the most formative of my whole life. I mean, those are the years you go from not knowing what you want to do and what talents you have to knowing what you really can excel at personally, what your mind is capable of. And that really transformed me as a person during those years.
I've always said that going to Purdue was the single best professional decision that I've ever made in my life. It follows me to this day. I'm 52 years old. I made that decision when I was 21.
I mean, the great thing about a degree is it can never be taken from you. You get to have that for the rest of your life.
And it is the biggest reason I'm here today, no doubt about it.
And it means the world when you know that someone is backing you up and I'm gonna do something amazing because I know that somebody's putting that faith in me and allowing me to do things that I didn't think were even possible.
For a little black kid from Kokomo, Indiana, that came here, that they took a flyer on, and it panned out. I put my work in, God provided the opportunity, but Purdue molded me.